Danielle to try?
Okay.
So, what are we doing?
We're going to make twine. We're going to do twine right now. You just start pulling it apart from the middle.
Hey.
So you get a lot of threads. Now, this isn't the only way to do this. There are other ways that people did it in bulk. But this is one way. You need cordage or rope right away. Normally, you would take your yucca, shred it, let it dry so it shrinks a bit on you, then you would do your weaving. But I want you to see how to make twine, and you need it right away. And what would you need twine for? What might you need it for?
Twining.
I like Billy said, for twining. How do you like that? What else? Okay, let's be more specific. Humor him with details.
Soap?
Okay, is that a twine use? Is that a rope use? Yeah, you will make soap.
But shelter?
What are some of, why, if you need to tie a shelter together.
Yeah.
Tie Jim's hat on when it's windy. What else?
Bow deer.
For the bow drill to make fire. What? Make a snare wire to catch a rabbit.
Tie something down.
For your shoestring, maybe.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Fix your pants.
Fix your pants, make a basket, make a brush.
Make nets.
Make sandals. So there really are a lot of uses. And keep in mind, we're using yucca. You could use any fibrous material to simply make twine.
So we have to take this apart.
Okay.
Yeah, I want you to take it apart so you get a lot of threads, and I'll show you how to do the twining and how to make it longer, how to extend it.
Do that for.
Well, you're not wrapping
it. The ability to make twine is like one of the most basic skills that you would then use for use. You could use all that twine for making nets, for example, or hammocks, for carrying bags. Braiding is where things lie flat. We use three or more. So for a hat band, a belt, and straps, you do braiding. I'm going to do twining, which usually has a more universal application. So you see what I'm doing? I'm just shredding it, and you guys are doing well. Now, when you take these leaves and agitate it with water, you can feel how it's already sticky. So you mix it with water, and you will get soap. But it'd be easier, thanks, to do this first, to make the twine first. Because once it's all sticky and soapy, it's going to be hard for you to do your twining. Okay, so you want something like this. Okay? You could make it finer, but this is good enough for me to show you how to make the twine now. Who all knows how to twine already? Anyone? You do? Didn't Tom Brown teach you how to do it?
Yeah, he did.
So you do know, but you forgot.
It's been a while,
okay. Just checking. Not trying to give you a hard time. Okay. So, get a little twig. Garrett, can you pass a twig around, Gary?
Yeah.
Okay, get a little twig like this. See, I'm draping the twine over the twig, so it's about half on each side.
How many?
Just a few, because you can make it as thick or as long as you want. But for our practice, I want you to make it on the thin side, and then we're going to add more of your twine onto it. If you were to make a sandal with what we're doing today, you'd want a thick, about 15 feet of a relatively thick, like your little finger, twine to make a sandal, one sandal. It takes a lot of fiber. Okay, now check this out, what I'm going to do. I'm twisting the right one and the left one. Twisting away. And if it's really wet, it's hard. I'm twisting this way, pulling it to the left. Twisting it away, twisting outward, pulling it to the left. So the stick just helps you get started and it gives you a little loop. Twist to the right, pull to the left. Twist to the right, pull to the left. Okay, did y'all get that? I'll come around and help you. But once you get that, it's pretty easy. You just do the same thing over and over, then adding on to it is another step. Got it? The spiral can be tight, it can be open, it all depends on what kind of basket you want to make. But if you can imagine what an onion basket looks like, you know, a garlic basket that has a lot of open space, that's more likely what you're going to do today. Okay, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll do 8. Could be more. It's usually not going to be less. But just so you understand the principle of how to do
it. Even number?
I like using 6, actually.
She likes using 6. It doesn't have to be an even number. No, it doesn't even have to be an even number. Not with what I'm going to show you. I'm going to trim it down to a size that's going to approximate a little bit bigger than the basket I'm going to make. It could be pointy. If it was going to be pointy like the, remember the cornucopia? You'd actually start from a bundle like this and I'd actually tie it on like so. Okay, that's actually pretty simple. But I'm going to demonstrate the more traditional basket. Like, did you all see the round baskets in the jar? Okay. Get all your leaves off. I got four and four. I'm going to turn them so that not all the big points are on one end, right? Okay.
That's so,
your basic framework is referred to as your warp, or you could say your spokes, like spokes in a tire. And then your weave or your weavers go spiral around. So the initial setup, did somebody have some question? What'd you say?
I was asking about periwinkle.
Oh, this is periwinkle, yeah. So I want to start with a good weaver that's strong and not going to snap. And longer is always better, obviously, so you're not constantly adding new ones.
I've also found that if you start with one that's thin and it's long, it's a lot better than if you get a thicker one, because the thicker ones tend to snap or just kind of bend funny. And so the thinner ones just are a lot more flexible.
Yeah, in the beginning.
Because of how you tie it up.
All things are kind of relative, but I would have to agree with that in general. Okay, so I'll help you do this too, but I want you just to watch. In fact, I'm going to do a quick demo, and then maybe we could all do it together so you get it. But I have four, as I look at them vertical, four horizontal on the top, the way I begin. And there's many other variations. Somebody might say this is wrong because you were taught something different. It's different. Okay, there's a lot of ways to do it. I'm grabbing it underneath like so. Mm-hmm. I'm creating an X on the top. Mm-hmm. Like so. See that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm holding it tight. You want the bottom to be tight. I'm rotating it like so. Pulling the two weavers over the top.
Mm-hmm.
So I've secured my base. Right? You're all going to do this. Taking my left hand and pulling this weaver through into this open quadrant here. These are my weavers. Now my job is to spiral around with one above and one below. Okay, I've twisted them like so. You can kind of see the order that they lay out in. You want each spoke now to be wrapped. And the tightness with which you wrap it depends on what you're trying to achieve. You do a 180 twist. Think of the two weavers as one, right? Put a spoke in. Okay? Yeah. Try to be gentle so you're not snapping all these. Twist, always twist in the same direction. And put a spoke in. See that? So the first cycle, you want all of the spokes to be spread evenly. Twist, put in a spoke. They should all be more or less equidistant. I'm on this next bundle, pull one in, twist like so, twist the weavers, put in a spoke, twist the weavers. See, if Bob could do it, you guys can do it. Hey, Bob?
Yeah.
Twist the spokes. Now, I'll keep doing it until I run out of weavers so you see how to add on, because you'll be constantly adding on. This cycle could be really close, or there could be space. It all depends on what you want to do. When people say to me that this is just the way the basket happened, well, sometimes that's true, because the fiber kind of has a mind of its own. But you're the one that's, you're choosing what you're going to make.
You're the director and producer.
There you go.
Kind of.
Up to a point.
Always that element of humility.
Okay, those are pretty low, pretty small, pretty short. You put another one to add on to it. Okay, I like that one. Okay, let's do it. Now, there's other ways to do it. When you see baskets with knots and nails, like at Trader Joe's, sometimes nails, those are made in the Chinese prisons. As far as I presume. I don't know how else they can send it to this country and sell it to us for $7 a basket. And the ones that have knots in them, those are referred to as white man's baskets. The Indian baskets never had knots. So here, instead of a knot, you would just drape the new one over and you twist. And you could do a double or fold the other ones out of the way. As this dries, it all will tighten up. So you just do a twist. Each, you have a weaver. I actually did it differently, but there's like two weavers, so each, it's above and below. And you're, so you're basically doing twisting it, so each weaver is going above, below, above, below.
Sure, I did it the same way you did.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I'm just using multiple strands, but it's the same exact thing.
Oh, okay. So I stand corrected. Okay, now. Now, you can just, these little pieces that stick out, you can cut them off later. And you just keep going. See, you know, you can do it slow. You're going to do it slowly. Now, if you want the sides to come up, you have to manipulate them upward as you twist around so they can start to curve upward. Otherwise, you're going to end up making a plate. So you have to manipulate. I used to press it on my body.
You're the director.
Yeah, you're, as Jim says, you're the director. Now, another thing you could do is give me some of your... I want to just show you another beginning way. Let me see your stuff. So you guys are going to get started, and I'll just... We'll go around and make sure you all can do it properly. Another thing you could do, if you want to make an oblong basket, is you start your weavers right here, yeah, rather than the X. And then you start spreading them, so you're going to end up with a more oblong basket. What are you going to make? One of these kind of baskets or a cornucopia? Okay. I'll demonstrate cornucopia, and then you guys can get started. Who's
in
these?
Normally, you would...
Question and issue in regard to basket making. You know, you need a basket right away, you just use what you got and you do the best you can with it. But there are lots of plants that harvesting time, the time of year, is essential. Very, very essential. Because even with periwinkle, sometimes, certain times of year, you'll gather it, it's just going to break like crazy. Yeah. You just won't be able to even make a basket. But other times of year, sometimes you just look out. You know, you happen to get it. This seems like it's a pretty good time right now. It's pretty strong.
Yeah.
But with willows, you have to get them just at the right time. Ideally, if you want to make like a super duper. You know,
spring, when the willow.
It depends on the willow, and it depends on what part of the country, what area you're in. So you get to know all of these things. It gets pretty involved. But this is great because you just have fun learning the basics, how to make a basket. Yeah, it's phenomenal. You apply these principles any place, anywhere.
So, yeah, so don't get too, don't worry about so-and-so says such and such. There are many, many, many ways to do it. If you'd be laughing at me if you saw my early baskets, because I didn't have anybody teaching me. I just kind of figured it out as I went along. Okay, cornucopia, I mean, it's true. I just tried to figure it out. Cornucopia, you bundle them like so, but you do your same, little V. And we start spreading them, make this really tight. You find the next one that comes in. We're going to spread each of the spokes. Okay. See how I'm doing that? Now I didn't tie any knot at the base, and I've seen some people do that.
Yucca or what?
I'm just going around until I get them all spread evenly.
I mean, I got these.
Guys, have questions?
I have yucca in my pocket. That doesn't work.
So you saw the cornucopia at the beginning, right? Dried cornucopia one?
Is this yours?
Yeah.
Yeah, but let's make one and then we'll...
So see what I'm doing? I'm just kind of looking to see how they all set together. Okay. And now I've actually finished my first cycle. Okay, then you just keep doing that. You can make this spread as much or as little as you want. Make the cornucopia type burden basket or gathering basket or whatever.
And you can go in and out.
A lot of,
any shape you want.
Okay, so, ready to begin? Take all of your vines, strip the leaves off, you know, and you notice you want to get at least 8 spokes, trim the root end where it's stiff, and then make them kind of the same length. All right, so we got plenty of work.
This is the,
Ashley can walk and make baskets at the same time.
Hey! How's it going?
Good.
You want to see?
Sure.
Yucca and willow. I love willow because it's so flexible.
Awesome.
Cool.
So you twist it kind of like you're making twine, but you wrap it around each...
Well, kind of, yeah. I mean, Christopher will probably show everybody, but it's just the in and out of, you know, like... Right here. So I'm there, and then I literally just twist it.
Just one twist?
Yeah, so it's kind of like making twine, but not exactly,
okay,
because you're just twisting it around the
spokes. At one point, you will want to start going up, right?
Yes,
How do you do that?
You just start bending these up more.
Oh, okay.
But I've learned that if I start bending them up right away, my basket looks like a flower, and it doesn't sit very well. And if you wait too long, you end up with a plate. So I just haven't started bending my edges up yet. I will.
Okay.